गुड मॉर्निंग। यस्टरडे यू हैव स्टडीड द डबल इंटीग्रेशन मेथड, यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द स्लोप एंड डिफ्लेक्शन। ओके, द ड्रॉबैक ऑफ द डबल इंटीग्रेशन मेथड इज दैट इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू राइट डाउन द इक्वेशन व्हेन द नंबर ऑफ लोडिंग्स आर देयर ऑन द बीम। फॉर ईच लोड वी हैव टू राइट वन इक्वेशन क्लियर, और देन यू हैव टू यूज द सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम, एंड बाय यूजिंग दैट सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम यू कैन कैलकुलेट द slope and deflection at any particular point. Okay, to overcome this difficulty, here Macaulay suggested one method. It is similar to the double integration method. It is a slight modification in the double integration method. Okay, so Macaulay suggested that when the number of forces or loading are acting on the beam, here instead of considering the each force at once, here we can consider all the forces together. And only there is a modification to write down the general equation of the bending moment. Okay, Macaulay suggested one special method to write down a single equation of bending moment which will be valid for all the part of the beam. Okay, directly I am going to explain you this Macaulay's method by considering this sum. Now in this sum, it is a simply supported beam which carries the point load of 20 kN at point C, 30 kN at point D, and an anti-clockwise moment of 20 kN·m. In this question, it is asked to calculate the deflection at point D, slope at point A, and you have to calculate the maximum deflection here in this entire beam, at which point there will be the maximum deflection and how much. Here, this you have to calculate. Okay, now in Macaulay's method, here we have to consider the same differential equation of the elastic curve here, that is EI into d square y upon dx square, which is equal to m. This m is the equation of the bending moment. Now here only in the double integration method we write down, we used to write the general equation of the bending moment, but there was a single loading. Yes, so it was easy to write down the equation of the bending moment. Macaulay suggested one different method only to write down the single equation of the bending moment for the entire beam. So that only you have to remember, and this step is only important, how to write down the general equation of the bending moment which will be valid for the entire beam. Okay, so Macaulay suggested that you consider origin. You can consider the origin on right end, or you can consider the origin at the left end, left or right, anywhere you can consider. But personally, I will suggest you consider the origin on the left end support. Even if it is a overhanging beam, suppose such type of overhanging beam is there here. So left end pay you have to consider as a origin. Okay, not necessary that it should be at origin here, but at left support you have to consider as a origin. Okay, after that, considering the origin for each part, now you will observe that here from A to C there is one equation of the bending moment. Now because of this 20 kN here, after C here the bending moment equation will vary. Okay, similarly after D also the equation of the bending moment varies. Here means for each part of the beam here, where there is a loading here, after that the equation of the bending moment varies. But we have to, Macaulay suggested one method here by using which we can write down a single equation of the bending moment which will be valid here from A to B. Okay, now how to write down this equation here? Listen, AI into d square y upon dx square, which is equal to, now we have to write down the general equation of the bending moment. So let's start from the origin. Here origin at the left end. Now consider a section at a distance of section xx, at a distance of x from A, or from origin I can say. Okay, and let's write down the equation of the bending moment here. You know that bending moment at any section is the algebraic summation of the moment of all forces on any one side. Now on the left side of this section, here there is only one force, which is RA. Okay, so I forgot to tell you, the first important thing is that here you are supposed to calculate that RA and RB. Okay, here, so I will write it directly that on the values of RA and RB, because let not waste the time here to calculate that RA and RB. Here all of you know the procedure to calculate that RA and RB. So here here RA is equal to this RA equal to 30.9 kilonewton. You can cross check later, and this RB is equal to 19.1 kilonewton. Later you can cross check. Okay, I'm not going to waste the time to calculate the support reaction because the sum is very lengthy. Now we have to write down the general equation of the bending moment. So for that, let's consider one section between A and C at a distance of x from origin. Okay, and let's write down the equation of the bending moment. So here, this on left hand side, there is a single point load. It produces a sagging moment, so it is positive. Here it is positive 30.9 into x. Okay, now this bending moment equation is valid here for the value of x from 0 to c or 0 to 2 meter. Here, so make it one dotted line here and write it here 0 and here 2. Means up to this dotted line, this bending moment equation is valid up to 2 meter only. From 0 to 2 meter or up to 2 meter from origin, this equation is valid. This equation of the bending moment will not valid after 2 meter. Okay, so it is 30.9 into x. Here, if you substitute x equal to 0, you will get the bending moment at point A. If you substitute x equal to 2, you will get the bending moment at point C. Okay, so we have to write down the general equation of the bending moment and not the value of the bending moment. Okay, so this is the first, this is the bending moment equation for the first part. Here, after that, draw one dotted line and write down this value of x from which to which this equation is valid. Okay, then because of this 20 kilonewton which is acting at point C, here, the equation of the bending moment varies. Here after C, this equation is not valid. Okay, so that's why I will consider one another section after C. You have to consider the section in each part where the bending moment equation varies. So I am considering the again one section between C and D, which is again at a distance of x from E. Consider one section between C and D, which is again at a distance of x from A. A only, from origin only. Here, instead of saying that A, I would say that it is origin. So you have to consider the section here at a distance of x from origin, and then write down the bending moment equation. Here, I am writing it separately. Here, I am writing the bending moment equation separately here. Here, at this second section, xx. So this bending moment equation. Now, what is bending moment? It is the algebraic summation of the moment of all forces on any one side. Here, so I am considering the forces on left hand side. Now, on left hand side of this section, these two forces are there. So I have to take the summation of that two moment of the two forces to get the bending moment at this section xx. Here, so what is the moment produced by this 30.9? It is sagging. So it is 30.9 plus 30.9 into how much is the distance of this from section? It is x. And this moment produced by this 20 is hogging. So it is minus. It is 20 into how much is distance from the section? We are taking the moment about the section. So how much is the distance from the section? This distance is x. This is 2. So how much is this distance? It is x minus 2. Here, this equation gives you the bending moment equation from C to D. Means this equation of the bending moment is varies when x varies from 2 to 5. When x varies, x is a distance from the origin. X is always a distance from the origin. So this equation is varies here from x equal to 2 to 5. Understood? Here this equation of the bending moment is not valid before 2 meter and after 5 meter. I mean, this equation is valid only from C to D. But if you observe this bending moment equation, here this first part is already it is written. Okay, but this part is only valid up to 0 to 2 here, and this part we have to further add it. So this term need not to repeat. Okay, so ahead of this only I am going to write the moment of this RA already I have written. Okay, because every time I am considering the distance of that section from distance of that section is x from origin. Okay, here so the moment of this RA already I have written. Just I have to add the moment of this 20. So it is minus 20 into x minus 2. Here, so from beginning this much equation I have to use here from 2 to 5. Okay, here if any value of x is from 2 to 5, so I have to use this entire equation. If any value of x here is from 0 to 2, here you can use this much equation only. Okay, here. So in this way, now this entire equation is valid up to d, only up to 5 meter. After d, because of this 30 newton, here you have to consider again one section. Let this section is xx. Again, this section is xx at a distance of x from origin. This section is again, I am considering at a distance of x from origin. Okay. Now you will observe that if I want to write down the equation of this bending moment at this section xx, here the moment of this RA is 30.9 into x, which is already written. Moment of this 20 here is Hawking, so minus 20 into this distance. Now, if this is x, here then how much is this distance? So it is x minus 2, this already we have written here. And then the moment of this 30 is again Hawking, so minus 30 into, how much is the distance of that 30 from this section? So it is x minus 5, this distance is 5, this is x. So how much is the distance of this 30 kilonewton force from the considered section? So it is x minus 5, that term only you have to add. Okay, so this entire equation of the bending moment is varies from d to e. Because of this moment, after e also the equation will change. Here means this much equation is valid here from 5, x equal to 5 to x equal to 9. This is 4 meter. Here, so it is 9. Here, so if any value of x is in between 5 to 9, you have to consider the entire equation. Okay, this much equation is up to 5 meter, this much equation is up to 2 meter, this much equation is up to 9 meter. Okay, here, then because of this moment, again after E, the bending moment equation varies here. So let's consider one section after E here, and consider again this section is at a distance of x from origin. And let's write down the bending moment equation here. Now here again I am writing this bending moment equation separately. Here you have to consider, now once you have started from left hand, you have to go from the left hand side only, and you have to write down the general equation. You may say that, sir, it is very easy to write down the equation from the left hand, right hand side now. If I consider this distance is x, then it is 19.1 into x. But in that case, B is the origin. We don't have to change the origin every time. Here for SFD, BMD calculation, here since we have to calculate the value of the bending moment, in that case, you can consider left hand forces or right hand forces of the section. But here, once you have started from the left hand side, so you have to go from the left hand side only, because you have to write down the single equation which will be valid for the entire B. Okay. Now, let's consider this section xx in between E and B, which is at a distance of x from the origin A or O. Now, let's write down the bending moment equation over here, considering the forces which are on the left hand side. Here, so look at the board, I am writing this equation again separately. So, मुझे यहाँ पे bending moment का equation लिखने का है, okay? And I am considering the forces on left hand side. So, let's consider this RA force. It producing the sagging moment. So, it is 30.9 into x. Its distance from the section is x. Then moment of this 20 is Hawking. So, minus 20 into, how much is the distance of this 20 newton kilonewton force from this section? Now, this distance is x, and this is 2 meter. So, the distance of this point load from the section is x minus 2. It is x minus 2. Okay. Then the moment of this 30 kilonewton force about this section, it is Hawking, so minus. It is 30 into, how much is the distance of this 30 kilonewton force from this section? So this section is at a distance of x from A. And this 30 kilonewton is at a distance of 5 from A. So what is the distance between these two? So it is x minus 5. Okay. Here, now listen. This moment is remaining. Listen carefully. In our general calculation of the bending moment, here if any moment is there, we used to write that moment directly. This is important. Okay. In our general bending moment equation, when we used to write down the general equation of the bending moment, here we write that moment directly. Here this moment is on left hand side, it is clockwise, so it is positive. Okay. And we used to add this moment directly. यार हम लोग मोमेंट का मोमेंट नहीं लेते थे, हम लोग मोमेंट को डिस्टेंस से मल्टीप्लाई नहीं करते थे. यार वी राइट दिस मोमेंट डायरेक्टली, वी ऐड दिस मोमेंट डायरेक्टली. यार दिस इज अ जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ द बेंडिंग मोमेंट. बट मैकॉले सजेस्टेड वन स्पेशल वे टू राइट डाउन द मोमेंट इक्वेशन. यार whenever there is any couple or moment is present in the system, here what you have to do? Here you have to add it. This is the tagging, so plus. That moment is 20. Here also, that 20 also you have to multiply this distance. Now this moment is acting at point E. Here, so I want this distance. So how much is this distance? Now from A, this section is at a distance of x meter. And this E point is at a distance of 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 2, 9. So from A, E point is at 9 meter. Section is at a distance of x meter. So how much is this distance? This will be x minus 9 here. So multiply this 20 by x minus 9 raised to power 0. Okay. Here 20 into x minus 9 raised to power 0. Ultimately, since it is raised to power 0, means this becomes 1. So it is 20 into 1. Ultimately, we are going to get the same answer, isn't it? Here in normal equation of the bending moment, we used to add this moment directly without multiplying by the distance. But Macaulay suggested to calculate the slope and deflection, here you have to add this moment or the couple here in that equation and multiply by the distance like a force. Here, but power 0. Here, power 0 means its value is 1. Isn't it? Here, I have understood this. It is 20 into x minus 9 raised to power 0. Here, this thing you have to remember in Macaulay's method. Okay. Here, so now this is the moment, bending moment equation that we have written. Here, this is the new things which you have to remember. Now, if you observe here, this equation up to this 30 into x minus 5, already we have written. It is same equation, because every time we are considering the section is at a distance of x from the origin. Here, same equation is there. Only I have to add this moment of this couple. Here, so it is plus 20 into x minus 9 raised to power 0. And this equation is valid up to B. Means up to from 9 to 11. This distance is 2, so it is 9 to 11. Okay. So up to 2 meter, you have to use this much equation. Up to 5 meter, you have to use this equation from start to this dotted line. Up to 9 meter, you have to use this entire equation up to this. And 11, up to you have to use this equation. Okay, here. Now, you are here, listen to me. Whenever the value of this bracket becomes negative, here after that or from that, here you have to ignore the next equation. Here, जब तक ये ब्रैकेट का वैल्यू यार पॉजिटिव है यार टिल ओनली यू हैव टू कंसीडर दैट इक्वेशन यार वंस इट बिकम नेगेटिव यू हैव टू इग्नोर दैट यार मींस फॉर एग्जांपल इफ एक्स इक्वल टू 6 एंड इफ यू सब्स्टिट्यूट एक्स इक्वल टू 6 इन दिस इक्वेशन ओके यार नाउ एक्स इक्वल टू 6 कम्स इन दिस रीजन 5 टू 9 के रीजन में सो यू हैव टू यूज द बेंडिंग मोमेंट इक्वेशन हियर. Up to this, you can observe that the value of this bracket is positive. But after this, the value of this bracket is negative. So once the value of the bracket is negative, here you have to ignore the equation. Okay. Have understood this? This is the general equation of the bending moment, which you have to remember how to write. Here, this equation is normal. Only here, whenever couple or moment is present, here you have to write in a proper way. That moment into distance raised to power 0. Okay, so this is a general equation of the bending moment which is valid for this entire beam. Okay, only you have to take the section, your proper dotted line you have to write here, and up to that dotted line only you have to use the equation. Understood? Here, any doubt?
Here, sir, is that, hello? Sir, is that power always 0 or any other?
Whenever there is a moment is present here, when we take the moment of the because we are writing the equation of the moment, bending moment here. So in our normal method, if such type of moment is there, we used to add directly. But now in Macaulay's, he has suggested that we multiply it by the distance here. But that distance is the distance of that moment from the section, that is x minus 9 raised to power 0. Is 0 hi aega idhar ye 0 aane ki wajah se here iska value ban gaya 1. And ultimately you are going to get it 20 only. Here, so uska power 0 hi aega, baki nahi aega. Whenever there is a moment. Here, baki jagah pe, when you take the moment of this force, yahan pe power 1 hai. Okay. Whenever there is a moment, there only you have to take it 0.
ओके सर,
सर इज देयर
थैंक
टू
यू.
मोमेंट्स? हेलो,
इज देयर, हाँ,
इज देयर
इफ
टू
यू,
मोमेंट्स?
इफ इट इज देयर, देयर आर टू मोमेंट्स क्लियर. लेट कंसीडर एट पॉइंट सी ऑल्सो देयर इज वन मोमेंट ऑफ टेन. ओके क्लियर. सो फर्स्ट सेक्शन इज एज इट इज. नाउ इन सेकेंड मोमेंट क्लियर, यू हैव टू राइट दिस मोमेंट ऑफ दिस आर ए यू आर ऑलरेडी रिटन. देन मोमेंट ऑफ दिस 20, आई एम कंसीडरिंग नाउ दिस मोमेंट एट 10 किलो न्यूटन मीटर एट पॉइंट सी. नाउ लेट कंसीडर दिस सेक्शन विच इज अगेन एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ एक्स फ्रॉम ओ. क्लियर. सो मोमेंट ऑफ दिस 30 इज 30.9 इंटू एक्स. मोमेंट ऑफ दिस 20 इज 20 इंटू दिस डिस्टेंस विच इज एक्स माइनस 2. दिस ऑलरेडी आई हैव रिटन. नाउ आई हैव टू एड द मोमेंट ऑफ दिस मोमेंट because this moment is in this region now. Now it is which type of moment? Again it is a sagging moment. So plus, it is a sagging moment. So it is plus. It is 10 into, this moment is acting at point C. What is the distance of that point C from the section? This distance is how much? It is x minus 2. So it is x minus 2, but since it is the moment, raised to power 0. Here in second part it will come. Understood? Even if there are two moment and all these things, you have to consider that in that particular part. Any doubt? Please ask
no,
me
sir.
If you have any doubt. Okay. Here, so I'm ignoring this additional 10 kilonewton. Okay. So this is our bending moment equation. Now we have to calculate the slope and deflection. So we have to calculate, we have to write down the equation of the slope and deflection. Yeah. This is the differential equation. So to write down the equation of the slope, here let integrate this equation. Integrate this equation. If I integrate this equation, equation becomes EI into dy by dx. Here which directly can write theta also. Here which is equal to, now you have to write down this equation. Properly 30.9 into x square upon 2 plus c1. Now here when we integrate it, here constant of integration should be written in the first part itself. Don't write it at the end. If you write it at the end, and suppose if you want to calculate the slope here when x equal to 2 meter, here to aap yahan tak kai equation lenge ye slope ka. ओके आप यहां तक का इक्वेशन लेंगे स्लोप का एंड यू विल फॉरगेट दैट कांस्टेंट ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन. हियर सो हियर इन मैकलेस मेथड दैट कांस्टेंट ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन यू हैव टू राइट इट इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट ओनली व्हिच विल बी वैलिड फॉर द एंटायर इक्वेशन. ओके हियर बिकॉज दिस फर्स्ट टर्म विल कम इन एंटायर इक्वेशन एवरी टाइम. दैट्स व्हाई यू हैव टू राइट डाउन दैट कांस्टेंट ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट इटसेल्फ नॉट एट द एंड. हियर सो इट इज प्लस c1. सो दिस मच इक्वेशन ऑफ द स्लोप. नाउ दिस इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ स्लोप. So this much equation of the slope is valid here from 0 to 2 meter. If you want to calculate the slope at x equal to 1 meter, just substitute x equal to 1 meter here. After calculation of c1, just substitute x equal to 1, you will get the slope. In this equation, since the value of E and I are not given here, so in exam also, if the value of E and I are not given, then you have to calculate the equation or this answer in terms of EI. So here also you get the answer in terms of EI. Okay, so this much equation of the slope is valid from 0 to 2. Now as usual you have to solve. Now it is minus 20 into, now next very important thing, second important thing. The first important thing which I said, that was the moment of this moment. Here you have to multiply by the distance raised to power 0. The second important thing is whenever you are integrating this bracket, here this is the bracket of the distance. Whenever you are integrating that bracket, you have to integrate that bracket as a whole, considering it as a whole function. Here you have to integrate that. Understood? This, for example, this term is 20 into x minus 2. Here, don't split it 20x minus 40 and then don't integrate it later. Here, usko open mat karo. Here, don't expand, don't open. Here, you have to integrate it as a whole. Okay. Have understood this? Now here it is integration of 20 into x minus 2. Clear? Isko open karke integrate mat karo. You have to integrate it as a whole. Clear? So it is 20 as it is into. Here x minus 2 is the variable. So x minus 2 integrate, you consider it as a variable. So you have to integrate this term. Here, so x minus 2 raised to power 2 upon 2. We are considering it as a variable as a x. So what is the integration of x? It is x square upon 2. So similarly here, you have to write down x minus 2 whole square upon 2. So this becomes the integration. This is the second important part. Okay, which you have to remember. So what will be the integration of this bracket, whole bracket? It is x minus 2 whole square upon 2. So it is very easy. It is 2 to 5. Then integration of this, minus 30. Now no need to write down here constant. Constant is only once. Here it is minus 30. Minus 30 into x minus 5 square upon 2. This equation is valid from 5 to 9. Plus, now it is 20 into. Now what is the integration of this bracket? It is x minus 9 raised to power 0. So it is x minus 9 raised to power, suppose if it is x minus a raised to power n. So what will be the integration of this as a whole bracket? X minus a raised to power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. Yeah, so here it is x minus 9 raised to power 0 plus 1, that is 1 upon 1. So its integration will be x minus 9 raised to power 1 upon 1. Here, once you understood this, no need to write down that 1. Yeah, so iska integration I got 20 into x minus 9. Okay, here this becomes the equation of the slope. Okay, here I am simplifying that equation of the slope and writing once again. So equation of the slope is EI into theta. I am writing it theta now, dy by dx, which is equal to, here it is 30.9 divided by 2 into x square plus c1. This equation is valid from 0 to 2 minus 10 into x minus 2 whole square. This equation is valid from 2 to 5. Then minus 15 into 30 upon 2 is 15 into x minus 5 whole square. This equation is valid from 5 to 9, and plus 20 into x minus 9. This equation is valid from 9 to 11. This is the equation of the slope. Okay, provided you have to calculate that value of the C1, constant of integration, by using the boundary condition. Here yesterday I told you about the boundary condition and everything. Same concept you have to use. Okay, here only it is the modification of the double integration method, and modification is only here. How to write down the equation of the general equation of the bending moment, which will be valid for the entire beam, and second, how to integrate. These two things are only different in Macaulay's method. Okay, now to write down the equation of the slope deflection, this was the equation of slope. Now to write down the equation of deflection, again integrate this. Okay, I'm writing it directly now. It is EI into theta y. Here if I integrate dy by dx, it becomes y, because it is the equation of deflection. So EI into y equal to, it is 30.9. here into x square, so we have to integrate this, so it becomes x cube upon 3. So that 3 and this 2, it is upon 6. Okay, this equation, and plus c1x plus c2. Integration of c1 is c1x plus c2, another constant of integration, because we are integrating twice. Okay, this much equation of the deflection is valid from 0 to 2 meter. Okay, minus 10 into x minus 2. You have to integrate this bracket as a whole. So it is x minus 2 square. So it becomes x minus 2 cube upon 3. This equation is valid from 2 to 5. Minus 15 into x minus 5 cube upon 3. Okay, it is x minus 5 square. So its integration is x minus 5 cube upon 3. This equation is valid from 5 to 9. Then plus, it is 20 into, now it is x minus 9. So its integration is x minus 9 whole square upon 2. This equation is valid from 9 to 11 meter. Okay, this is the general equation of the deflection. Say these are the equation number 1, these are the equation number 2. equation one is the general equation of the slope. Equation number two is the general equation of the deflection. Okay, here by using this equation, you can calculate the slope and deflection at any point by substituting that corresponding value of the x in that equation. Clear? Suppose if I want to calculate the deflection at point D, which is at a distance of 5 meter from origin. So take the value of x equal to 5, but kahan tak? Here up to x, this, up to 5 meter, up to this only. After this, this term becomes 0. Yeah, so you don't have to consider this. 0 or negative hota hai, to nahi consider karne ka. Only positive term you have to consider. Yeah? So you have to consider only up to this. Yeah? And if you substitute x equal to 5 in this equation, you will get the deflection at x equal to 5, that is yd. Okay. Now, before proceeding, yeah, first you have to calculate this constant of integration. Okay. Now, to constant of integration, we have to use the boundary condition. Now, it is a simply supported beam. Yesterday, I told you that in simply supported beam, at the support, we are assuming that they are the non-yielding support. And at the non-yielding support, here we assume that the deflection is always zero. So we can use that as a boundary condition. Since there are two constants of integration, we require the two boundary conditions. Here, so I'm going to use the boundary condition to calculate this constant of integration. So I can write down at point A, there is one support. That is when x equal to 0. Here, y equal to 0, there is no deflection. Okay, if I substitute in this equation. Now, if I substitute it in this equation, y equal to 0, which is equal to. Now, x is also equal to 0. This x is also equal to 0. So this second term is also 0 plus c2. Okay. Now don't substitute x equal to 0 in this one, because after this, here this equation is valid when x equal to beyond 2. Okay. So this equation at x equal to 0, this equation is not valid. Here, if you substitute x equal to 0, this bracket becomes negative. Yes, so you have to consider only up to this. Here means you will get one constant of integration, that is c2 equal to 0. We got one constant of integration. Now to get the second constant of integration here of c1, you require another boundary condition. Now which other boundary conditions you can write for this beam? Now since it is a simply supported beam at point B, which is another support. At point B, that is when x equal to 11. At point B, x equal to 11. 2, 3, 4, 2. Here, so 4, 4, 8 and 3, 11. That is x equal to 11. Again, y equal to 0. Here, at point B, when x equal to 11 meter, y equal to 0. And now substitute in this equation. Okay. Now, you have to consider x equal to 11 meter. Means you have to consider the entire equation. Okay. Here, you have to consider the entire equation, not only this much part. Okay. Entire equation you have to consider. Here, you have to consider the effect of the all the loads. Here, so if I substitute that, here left hand side it becomes 0, which is equal to, it is 30.9 into 11 cube upon 6, I'm substituting the x equal to 11, plus 11 c1, c2 is 0, minus 10 upon 3 into 11 minus 2 whole cube. For your understanding, I'm writing this. Here, otherwise, I would have written directly 9, minus 15 upon 3 into 11 minus 5, 6 cube, plus 20 upon 2 into 2 square. Clear? If you simplify this, you will get the value of c1. Okay. Here the value of c2 is 0 and value of c1 comes minus 307.7. Okay, you cross check that answer. Here, but this is minus 307.7. Here, so to calculate that constant of integration, you have to use these boundary conditions. I am writing this constant of integration here, c1 equal to minus 307.7 and c2 equal to 0. Here, till now, any difficulty? If you have any difficulty, please tell me. Is that clear? Any doubt? Okay. Now we'll move further ahead. Now we have written the general equation of the slope. We have written the general equation of the deflection. Here we have calculated the constant of integration C1 and C2. Okay, I need only these two equations and value of C1 and C2 to calculate the slope and deflection. Now the first thing, what do you have to calculate? You have to calculate the deflection at point D. Here in the sum, this question is given and it is asked to calculate the deflection at point D. Here, so we have to calculate YD. Now we know that at point D, what is the value of X? X equal to 5 meter. Means we have to calculate the deflection when X equal to 5 meter by using this equation. This is the general equation of the deflection. So by using this equation number 2, we have to calculate the deflection at point D. So use this equation number 2. Here it is EI into YD, which is equal to. Now we have to substitute X equal to 5. तब तक सब्स्टिट्यूट करने का x इक्वल टू 5 हो, सो 5 मीटर तक इक्वेशन 5 मीटर तक, यहां तक ही 5 मीटर तक इक्वेशन वैलिड है, इसके बाद में नहीं. इफ यू सब्स्टिट्यूट x इक्वल टू 5 हियर, इट बिकम 0, सो इट हैज नो मीनिंग. इसके बाद में ये नेगेटिव आएगा. ओके, सो डोंट कंसीडर इट एज अ 0 और नेगेटिव. ओके, सो यू हैव टू कंसीडर द इक्वेशन ओनली अप टू 5 मीटर हियर एंड सब्स्टिट्यूट x इक्वल टू 5. सो इट इज 30.9 * 5 क्यूब / 6 + 5 C1. C1 is minus 307.7. It is C1, that value, X is 5. So I have substituted that. C2 is 0. So ignore. Minus 10/3 into 5 minus 2 whole cube. Here, remaining part, no need to consider. Simplify this. You will get this YD, which is equal to some constant upon EI. Okay. Here, can you calculate and tell me in 1 minute how much is that? Simplify and tell me how much is that? You first give my answer, then you write your name and roll number.
Minus 2 0.95.
Minus how much? Minus 2830.95. Here Tathang gate was something 1499 or something. Here in the book, answer is given as 981, minus 981, minus 981.25. This answer is given.
Minus sir, minus 984 आ रहे सर.
हाँ, 984 चलेगा, no problem. Here 984, 985, here in that range it's okay, no problem.
So 984.75.
Minus 984.75.
Okay, no problem. 984.75. If you substitute the value of E and I, because this is in terms of 10^6, and this is also in 10^6, something like that. Here, if you substitute that value, here this the difference in the final answer is very negligible. Even though you were finding it here 981 and 984, but answer difference in the final answer will be very negligible. Okay. Now here this minus sign indicate that at point D the deflection is in downward. Here so YD equal to, it is 984.74 upon EI in downward. Understood? Any doubt? If that would have been a positive, means the deflection is upward. It may happen. Yeah, sometimes deflection may be upward also. Okay. Here, so this negative sign indicates that the deflection is downward. For the slope, yesterday I told you that if the value of theta is positive, then the rotation is in anti-clockwise direction. If it is negative, the rotation is clockwise. Same thing here also. Okay, any doubt? So this is the slope at point D. Now we have to, sorry, this is the deflection at point D. We have to calculate the slope at A. Here, slope at A. So we have to calculate the theta A. Now at point A, what is the value of X? Now we have considered A itself as the origin. So if A itself as the origin, what is the value of x at point A? It is 0, isn't it? Yeah. So you have to calculate the slope when x equal to 0. Now use the general equation of the slope. Yeah, so it is EI into theta A, and you have to substitute x equal to 0. Okay, if I substitute x equal to 0, here I have to use the equation up to this 2 meter only, because after this brackets become negative. Okay, so ignore that. So only because the equation is valid only up to this, from 0 to 2 meter. When the value of x equal to 0 to 2 meter, you have to consider this much equation only. So use this much equation only of the slope. Now if I substitute here, the first term becomes 0 plus C1. C1 is minus 307.7. Yeah, so you will get theta A equal to minus 307.7 upon EI. This is the rotation at point A. Because of this loading, here when this beam will deflect like this, approximately the deflection will be like this. Here, so the slope at point A, if I draw the tangent at point A, here this rotation of the beam at point A is 307.7 upon EI. And again, this negative sign indicates that the rotation is in the clockwise direction. Okay, so this theta A equal to, it is 307.7 upon EI. This is in radian. And this negative sign indicates that this rotation is in the clockwise direction. Okay, this is theta A. In it out. Have understood this? Okay, then on this beam, let this is the deflected curve, or it is commonly known as the elastic curve. Here, very exaggerated figure. This is the YD which we have calculated here, and here we have calculated theta A. These two terms we have calculated. Now, the next, on this beam, here you have to calculate how much is the maximum deflection. We have to calculate the Y0. Okay. Now, remember one thing, when this beam gets deflect here, we have to calculate the maximum deflection. We have the general equation of the deflection for the entire beam, but it is in terms of x. If I would have known the value of x where the deflection is maximum, here by substituting that value of x in this equation, y become y max. I can calculate that. Means to calculate this y max, here first I need to calculate the value of x, means I need to calculate the position of that point where the deflection is maximum. यहाँ पे कैसे पूछा था कि कैलकुलेट द डिफ्लेक्शन एट पॉइंट डी. यार सो एट पॉइंट डी वी नो दैट एक्स इक्वल टू 5 मीटर. ओके सो बाय सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग एक्स इक्वल टू 5 मीटर हम लोग को वाईडी मिला. यार बट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वाई मैक्स, एंड आई डोंट नो इन दिस बीम यार वेयर इज द सेक्शन वेयर द डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज मैक्सिमम. At what distance x, the deflection is maximum. So first I need to calculate that x where the deflection is maximum. And yesterday I told you that here for this general equation, y as a function of x, this is a general equation. So for y max, I have to differentiate it with respect to x and equate it with 0. So aapko x mil jayega. This is the position of x where y is maximum. If I substitute that x in this equation, you will get y max. Isn't it? Here, but when we differentiate this equation of deflection, dy by dx, but what is dy by dx? It is theta. Okay, so remember this concept is here for y max, here the position where the deflection is maximum, the theta is equal to 0 for simply supported or cantilever beam. Sorry, for simply supported or the overhanging beam. Here for cantilever, it may not be 0, or this is not valid for cantilever beam. Yeah. So for y max, the theta is equal to 0. So first I will locate the position. Okay. So first I will locate the position here at which the deflection is maximum. Okay. So I can write here for y max, theta equal to 0. Yeah. So substitute in this equation theta equal to 0 and get the value of x. Here that equation you have to solve. ओके यार, सब्स्टिट्यूट थीटा इक्वल टू जीरो, सो जीरो इक्वल टू इट इज 30.9 अपॉन टू इनटू एक्स स्क्वायर. इट इज प्योरली बेस्ड ऑन द ट्रायल एंड एरर. यार आई डोंट नो यार कि दिस लोकेशन यार ऑफ वाई मैक्स वेदर इट इज इन फ्रॉम सी टू डी, ओके, और फ्रॉम डी टू बी और फ्रॉम बी टू सी, दैट आई डोंट नो. यार सो वी हैव टू डू इट बाय ट्रायल एंड एरर. यार सो जीरो इक्वल टू 30.9 अपॉन टू इनटू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस सी वन. C1 is minus 307.7. I'm using this equation. I'm equating this equation with 0 to get the value of x where the y is maximum. Minus 10 into x minus 2 whole square minus 15 into x minus 5 square plus 20 into x minus 9. Clear? This is the equation in terms of x. Now you have to simplify this equation. I will observe that here. This x square 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 everywhere square means this is a quadratic equation in x. If you simplify this, you will get a quadratic equation in x here. So for that quadratic equation in x, you will get the two values of the x, x1 and x2. I said two values milenge. Here you can directly use a solve function and get the two proper values. Here you should know how to get the two proper values by using the solve function. Now you are in third semester. Okay, when you type shift solve, here you have to enter some initial value. So once you enter the initial value 0, here then trial and error save, then substitute 5, like that you have to do that here, and you have to enter calculated by trial and error. Now for this equation, if you solve it by using the solve function, here the values are, one value is 5.13. Sorry, one small error here, small mistake is there. For y max theta equal to 0. Now, the thing is that I don't know here this maximum deflection is in which region, whether it is between A to B or B to C or from C to D, okay, here or from D to B. If I use this entire equation, I use the entire equation. It means that I am assuming that the maximum deflection is in the region D to B, because for D to B only I have to use the entire equation. Okay, so you have to do it for trial and by trial and error method. Here, so here what I am doing here, you have to initially assume. Yes, so just by observing this beam here, agar aisa deflected curve dekhenge, to aapko kahan pe lagta hai? Just imagination. यार आपको कहां पे लगता है कि डिफ्लेक्शन, मैक्सिमम डिफ्लेक्शन कौन से रीजन में हो सकता है? सिंपली सपोर्टेड बीम के मैक्सिमम डिफ्लेक्शन कौन से रीजन में हो सकता है? यस, सो यू कैन ऑब्जर्व दैट हियर इट इज अ 30 किलो न्यूटन लोड. हियर दिस स्पैन इज ऑल्सो 4 मीटर. ओके, मैक्सिमम लोड इज हियर, दिस स्पैन इज ऑल्सो 4 मीटर. सो आई विल assume initially ki let the maximum deflection is in the region PD. Here what you have to do, let maximum deflection, I already told you that this you have to do it by trial and error. Okay, so pehla trial mein consider kar raha hu ki let the maximum deflection is in the region CD. Let it is in the region CD. Here that is when x varies from, now from C to D, the x varies from 5 to 9. Here when x varies from 5 to 9. Yeah, so for that region, let equate theta equal to 0. So if I theta equal to 0, now I am using the equation only sir, to D.
No, sir, x varies Bolo. From 2 to 5. X varies from 2 to 5.
I am not getting x square equal to 2. X is sir, equal to 2 CD. To 5.
So for CD, x varies from 2 to 5.
Now for CD, how the x varies from 2 to 5? Listen. This is our simply supported beam. This point is B. Sorry, I made a mistake. This was D, C. This is D. this point is E and this is B, SIA. Okay, so I'm considering that the deflection is maximum in the region DE. Okay, not CD, it is in the region DE, where X varies from X equal to 5 to X equal to 9. Am I right? Now, is there any difficulty? Why you are saying that it is 2 to 5? Why 2 to 5? You consider this original CD. Okay, for this original CD, now if you consider this CD now, here then for this CD the X varies from 2 to 5. That is correct. Here, but I am assuming that the maximum deflection not in the region CD, I am assuming that it is in the DE, which is the middle part, load bhi jyada hai, span jyada hai ye load iska. Okay, that's why I am considering that here the maximum deflection is in the region DE, not CD. That was the mistake. Okay, now for DE, X varies from 5 to 9. Is it okay now? Have understood this? Okay, now since we are considering the maximum deflection from the region 5 to 9, so this in that region only the slope becomes 0. So I have to use this equation only up to X equal to 9. यहां तक का ही इक्वेशन यूज करने का है, ये लास्ट पार्ट यूज नहीं करने का है. ओके क्लियर? सो दिस इक्वेशन इज वैलिड अप टू 9 मीटर नाउ. इनफैक्ट इट इज वैलिड फ्रॉम 5 टू 9. क्लियर? नाउ सिंप्लीफाई दिस एंड गेट द इक्वेशन ऑफ एक्स. क्लियर? सो एक्स वन आता है, इफ यू सिंप्लीफाई दिस, यू जस्ट इफ यू हैव द कैलकुलेटर जस्ट ट्राई, यूज द सॉल्व फंक्शन एंड टेल मी द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. Here, since it is a quadratic equation, you will get the two answers. Try this and tell me the answer. अपना ये x1 और x2 का आंसर इसके बीच में अगर आता है, 5 to 9 के बीच में, दोनों में से कोई भी एक अगर ये रेंज के बीच में आता है तो our first assumption is correct. Okay, अगर नहीं आता है then you have to go for the second assumption. Yes, and remember the maximum deflection is always away from the support. Here support ke paas maximum deflection nahi hoga. In this case, in part AC and in part EB, the maximum deflection hoga hi nahi. It will be either in the part DE or CD. Here by email, just by experience, I consider that it will be in the part DE. Here, so DE agar consider karte hai, to X1 or X2 ka value 5 to 9 ke beech mein hi aana chahiye. Tell me how much is that? Use solve function. Here this answer, one root is 5.13 and second root is something 14.65. Use solve function and let's check. आया क्या आंसर? आता है क्या ये आंसर? These are the correct answer. Okay. Now you can observe, we are assuming that the maximum deflection, this is our for assumption. We have to do it by trial and error. Here, so for region DE, agar equation likhte hai, here theta equal to 0. So one of the root is in this consideration. Here we want X is in between 5 to 9. So it is in this consideration. अगर ये रेंज में अगर नहीं आता था, दोनों में से एक भी रूट अगर ये रेंज में नहीं आता था, तो देन यू हैव टू गो फॉर द सेकंड ट्रायल. क्लियर? देन यू हैव टू अज्यूम दैट लेट द मैक्सिमम डिफ्लेक्शन इज इन द रीजन सीडी. क्लियर? सो अगर वो कंसीडर करते हैं, यार लेट मैक्सिमम डिफ्लेक्शन इज इन रीजन सीडी, दैट इज देन एक्स वैरीज फ्रॉम 2 टू 5 फॉर सीडी, एक्स वैरीज फ्रॉम 2 टू 5. ओके और अगर आप ये स्लोप, देयर द स्लोप इज जीरो, इफ यू राइट दिस इक्वेशन, सो इट इज जीरो इक्वल टू 30.9 अपॉन 2 इनटू एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 31307.7 हियर माइनस 10 इनटू एक्स माइनस 2 होल स्क्वायर अपॉन, नो दैट मच ओनली, here, and you have to use the equation only up to 5 meter. So if you consider this equation here and if you calculate the value of x, so iska root aata hai 5.12 and second root aata hai -12.45. Okay, now you observe that if I consider the region CD, the x value should be between 2 to 5, but I am getting one root is 5.12, which is not in this region. Okay, and from this one I can conclude that here the maximum deflection is not in the region CD. Then you have to go for the second trial. Then what is the second trial? Let the maximum deflection is in the region DE, and here we observe that yes, this x value is in this limit of 5 to 9, and that's why we can conclude that the maximum deflection is in the region CD here at 5.13 meter. Understood? Here, so from this one we concluded that the maximum deflection is in the region CD here at y equal to 5.13 meter. Here, so y max is in the part CD at x equal to 5.13 meter. Okay, now substitute x equal to 5.13 meter in this equation and get the y max. Yes, so from equation number 2, here y max equal to, substitute x equal to 5.13 meter. Now since we are substituting x equal to 5.13 meter, so you have to use the equation up to 9 meter after 5. This point is after D. Here after 5 meter, so don't end over here only, you have to end here, because if I substitute x equal to 5.13, this value of the bracket is positive, after that it becomes negative, so you have to use the equation up to this to get the y max. So y max equal to, it is 30.9 into 5.13 cube upon 6, I am substituting the value of x, plus c1 is -307.7 into x 5.13, c2 is 0, -10 into 5.13 -2 whole cube upon 3, okay, upon ER. This gives you the maximum value of deflection in the region here, which is at x equal to 5.13 meter. This is the maximum deflection and this is the position where the deflection is maximum. Here this answer will also be negative, that negative sign indicate that it is in downward direction. Any doubt? Any doubt? Okay. If possible to one more sum is there, when UDL is there, okay, UDL ya to UVL agar hai, yeah, so how to do that? Here that sum is remaining. Yes, so one more hour is required to complete that sum. Any doubt in this question? Okay, thank you.
No, sir.
We'll stop here now. Those who have not written their name and roll number, please write your roll and name and roll number.